Now, Mark's been doing this pipe fitting by hand and then making paper templates, but if you go to, there's if you just Google pipe meter templates, or miter templates free, or and it's, we made the mistake, you can't look at the pipe joint, because joint, that's a 90 degree joint, so they give you the pattern of what to cut, and that's not what you want. What you want is a miter, because we got outside corners that are coming together, so we found one that does miters. And it's real simple. We have about 100 degree intersection between those pipes up there on the back. So you put in, see, our pipe is actually 3.5. And then we got about 100 degrees and plot points at a half inch apart. Just means how many numbers they're going to give you. And that you can actually then, you know, draw your own template, or we can print this one out. That's what we're going to do. They can do everything for you at RadioArc except put your plug back on. Thud. Now, the purpose behind the catwalk is so that we could go outside in front of the pilot house and then walk down outside the pilot house with lines, you know, for anchoring or tying off or dredging or whatever we may be doing. It's a work boat, so, you know, moving lines and hoses and that kind of thing is necessary. You don't want to be taking them through the galley. You know, Betsy wouldn't like that. So, and it's not actually our idea. This is actually an old idea. Chinese boats used to do this. Chinese boats were used for bays and traders and coastals primarily, and they'd go up rivers. So when they did that, two guys would get out there with very long poles. They'd stick that pole down in the river bottom at the front of the boat, and then they'd walk down these long catwalks outside the boat. Now, most of their catwalks, from what I can tell, it used to be they'd shove planks, timbers out. They'd have holes back in the hull for them, and push these timbers into those holes and then lay a board down outside of that. Because you don't want a lot of structure out there during heavy weather. It's just too much for waves to catch on. That's why ours is just going to be pipe. And then if we need to walk down it easier, we'll do the same thing. We'll just lay a board out there. Been out welding this morning while the wind was down. Now wind's coming back up, so we just finished tacking this side together. We're gonna go work on the other side today.
Yeah, let's stop there.
You good?
through it. Perfect. Keep going. All of it. Yeah, that's good.
There we go.
That'll be good enough.
It's right.
David Yaxis is here with us today, and he's got a little clever idea for if you got patience, this works great. But we got that blade set up to 30 degrees. Now you got to change it for whatever you're doing. But two 30 degree cuts off the end of that thing, and let me show you how it fits in.
And that's what you end up with, and through to a 3-inch pipe, it makes a nice weldable fit.
We just need a little bit more, what do you think, about a 45 instead of 30 degree if we're going to the same size pipe?
I can't remember.
Yeah. A little messing around with it. All right, you did good. Yeah, burning the tip isn't unusual. In fact, I normally have a bunch of them up here. I need to go get some. So we can put some ingots on top of that tomorrow.
Working on the port catwalk today, which is actually a little nicer because it didn't have all the braces the starboard one does. And packages going out to the mailman for you guys. Appreciate the support. But you know what? Listen, the stuff we sell, it's expensive. It's because you're paying for that. So if you don't have the extra money, don't do it, okay?
Yeah, just the hair.
Right. Makes a good take. Right there. Perfect. 34. Okay.
What we're fussing with is that back little pipe there, because what we saw is when we fit it in, we didn't have it out enough, so it wasn't kind of balanced with the other side. So now it's got a curve out in it, and it matches the other side. So we're gonna have to do a little fill work, but it's worth it.
Can I borrow a pair of gloves?
Yeah, in the box over there in the corner. girl from Eden Eva?
Yeah.
James Bond.
So what is this wire on here? Is that a governor of some sort?
Alright, batteries. That's what I need to get.
Yeah.
Under? Mm-hmm. Into, I guess they're drilling and tapping into the, yeah. Is that what you see done?
Yeah, you want to do it before your turbo. A lot of guys will do it after it exhausts, but you're not really getting.
The argument I heard is they're afraid it's going to break off and then it's going to destroy the turbo. Does that ever happen?
It does. What I would use, they have they call them thermo wells. You can just build one yourself.
But shit, you just put it on the outside?
Well, you drill a hole, and a thermo well has like an NPT tap, but it's solid, to where the thermocouple just fits down inside, and that way that the thermocouple will never break off, and it'll never...
Nothing to ever break off inside. So you drill a hole, you tap it, and you throw the thing in.
And they make those thermo wells out of stainless steel. So what I would do is, you drill it, tap it, put you a thermo well in, and put your thermocouple in a thermo well.
Oh, a thermal well?
Mm-hmm.
So it's just a piece of steel thermocouple goes in. I got it.
Yeah, so if you had like a...
Right.
A piece 3/4-inch bar, you could thread the bar with an NPT at the top, like turn it down on your lathe, thread the top NPT, and then drill a hole almost through the bottom.
Right.
And that way
you
just
have a thermal well.
Yeah. That way it doesn't fall off and get into your It's not as like instantaneous accurate, but it is accurate for a non-drag race, you know. You're not gonna be out there drag racing your boat.
Or not. Let's go pour some lead.
Yeah.
We're gonna get it above the solid blocks down in there. And then if we have some left over, and I think we will, I'll put a chute in here and we'll pour through this little hole into the other side. Okay. Sections, but till then, you know what, let's do, let's go ahead and work with the other side of the boat first, and then we'll just figure it out.
I had him, you know, several logs, sycamore about this big around,
three of those.
Yeah,
I
guess I'm 12 feet long.
Yeah,
close it downtown.
Cool.
The raft stays on so well.
And I think after that, like,
I can get my Mazda raft.
There you go.
Do they? Does it contour to the dents and everything that are already in the panel?
Will it hold the rust together?
Yeah. Yeah, go ahead and start it.
Well, the catwalks are coming along nicely, and this is the starboard side of the boat, and if we ever have to dock against something solid, we're going to use this side. If it's windy or something like that, we're going to bump up against it, so we get all the braces over here. So what we can do is we can put a board or plank, or you can just get a little gymnast in you, and you can actually walk down these. These are only 3 feet apart, so
And they're only tacked in right now, so I don't feel too terrible. Yeah, that'll be all right. And we can walk down these things. The idea is we can handle a line down the side of the boat without having to pass it through the pilot house, which would be nearly impossible. Now, the one on the other side doesn't have these steps because we're going to put a gangplank in it. So this is our port side, and that bar right there is our brace. And we're going to build some sort of a hinge here that's aluminum and UHMW, and it'll fold up and down, and then it will have a pivot pin on it so it can swing out to the side, because that steel brace there is just temporary. Once we get this pipe bent in place the way we want it, the gangplank runs from this hinge all the way down to the end there, and it's going to be built out of aluminum, four parallel pipes, and it will lower down into the water or to the ground or to the pier, and if we need to, it'll pitch out to the side too. So that's the idea, that's the plan. There'll be a winch or something, a hoist, you know, on the top of the pilot house roof at the back corner to pull it up. And I do believe Stephen has got us all welded up back there now.
Fuel pump arrived. Well, not the injector pump. It's the pump that pumps the fuel to the injector pump.